हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? आई होप यू ऑल आर फाइन एंड आई वेलकम यू ऑल ऑन माय यूट्यूब चैनल इकोनॉमिक्स एट योर होम बाय प्रियंका राय। सो स्टूडेंट, दिस टाइम आई एम गोइंग टू टेल यू द डिफरेंस बिटवीन ह्यूमन कैपिटल एंड ह्यूमन डेवलपमेंट। एज यू ऑल आर अवेयर विद द टर्म ह्यूमन कैपिटल, ह्यूमन रिसोर्स, नाउ यू आर गोइंग टू सी द ह्यूमन डेवलपमेंट। सो द टू टर्म्स साउंड सिमिलर बट देयर इज क्लियर डिस्टिंक्शन बिटवीन ह्यूमन कैपिटल। So we are going to see the difference between human capital and human development. So you can see, then human capital considers education and health as a means to increase labor productivity. So human capital considers education and health as a means to increase labor productivity. Labor productivity, what does it mean? Labor productivity means output produced by a labor per unit time, or you can say per hour. So human capital considers education and health as a means to increase labor productivity. That means if the investment is done in education and health, so labor productivity must be increased, the output produced must be good. Whereas human development is based on the idea that education and health are integral to human well-being. That means education and health go simultaneously, both are integral, both are necessary for a human well-being, because only when people have the ability to read and write and the ability to lead a long and healthy life, then only they will be able to make other choices which they value. So just being educated merely is not important, or just being healthy merely is not important. Both are essential, both are integral to each other in order to make choices which they value. Hope this point is clear. Human capital treats human being as a means to an end. So human capital treat human beings as a means to end, and the end being the increase in productivity. So human capital basically treat human beings as a means to an end, and this end means being the increase in productivity. So whereas human capital says that if there is investment in education and health and it is unproductivity, it does not enhance output of goods and services, then it's useless. So hence human capital treats human being as a means to an end, which means that there must be increase in productivity. Now let us see. So as I told you all, investment in education and health is unproductive if it does not enhance output of goods and services. Whereas human development perspective says human beings are ends in themselves. Human welfare should be increased through investments in education and health, even if such investments do not result in higher labor productivity. So therefore, basic education, basic health are important in themselves, irrespective of their contribution to labor productivity. Human capital states that if output is not good, then it's of no use. Whereas human development says that basic education and basic health are important in themselves, irrespective of their contribution to labor productivity. That means there's nothing to do with labor productivity. Human development, for human development, a basic education and basic health is very important. So hope this is clear to you all. What is the difference between human capital and human development? We have finished with human capital and human development. Now we will see problems which are faced in human capital formation. So students, the next topic is problem facing human capital formation in India. There are certain serious problems in the process of human capital formation, and these are as follows: rising population, brain drain, insufficient manpower planning, insufficient on the job training in primary sector, especially agriculture, and low academic standards. So now we are going to see how these are the problem in the process of human capital formation. Rising population. Rapidly rising population adversely affects the quality of human capital. Human capital is deeply affected, you can say, is adversely affected by the rising population, and it is rising rapidly. It reduces per head availability of the existing facilities that determine the quality of life and capacities to acquire knowledge and specialized skills. See what happened when the population is rising at an alarming rate, but obviously it is going to affect the quality of human capital. And it not only affect the quality of human capital, it also reduces per head availability of the existing facilities that determine the quality of life and capacities to acquire knowledge and specialized skill. Now these facilities that relates to housing, sanitation, drainage, water system, hospitals, education, electricity supply, etc. So somewhere you can say that the population which is rising, it's also affecting the quality of human capital. Now brain drain, what is brain drain? Number of trained people migrate from our nation to another nation, from one nation to another nation. So this is only called brain drain. Migration of persons born, educated, trained in India to developed countries is a serious threat to the process of human capital formation in India. Now these people sometimes say for having a better quality of life, for getting a better salary, they migrate from our nation to some other nations. And those who tend to migrate are persons of high caliber. They possess a high caliber, and they are consisting largely of scientists, administrators, executives, engineers, physicians, educationists, etc., whatever. So this is described as a problem of brain drain. So this is also a serious threat in the process of human capital formation, which should not take place. There is insufficient manpower planning, and only meager efforts have been made to maintain the demand-supply balance of the ever-rising labor force in the country. So there's insufficient manpower planning. Manpower planning is not sufficient, and very little effort has been done in this direction so as the demand and supply and the balance of the ever rising labor force in the country. As a result, India is facing one of the most explosive problems of discontent and frustration, that of graduate unemployment, and it is sad reflection on the wastage of human power and man skill. Nowadays we can see that population is increasing at an alarming rate, and what happens, the impact of that, its impact, what obviously we see on the quality of human life, but also we see that manpower planning is insufficient because there is a wastage of human power and human skill. They remain unemployed and lying just like that. So this is also a concern for a nation, and hence a problem which is being faced in the process of human capital formation in India. Now, next is what insufficient on the job training in primary sector. Primary sector, basically agriculture sector, is considered as a backbone of Indian economy, but unfortunately has not received due attention in the area of professional skills and acumen. What I want to say with this, that we haven't seen that agriculture sector is considered as the backbone of Indian economy. This revolution in industries and tertiary sectors is all came later. It's only due to primary sector that we have survived in the long run. And nowadays what happened, that the modern methods of agriculture, the modern inputs, the seeds, the quality, many things are not being recognized at that level. And India is deprived of such professional skills. So this again a threat, or you can say a problem, which is faced in the process of human capital formation in India. This sector continues to be driven by traditional wisdom and is almost devoid on the job training program. Basically, people think, what is the requirement of training programs in this field? No, there is a requirement, as every farmers are not educated, and they are not well versed with the modern farming technology. So they should be trained with that, and they can perform more better. So they need training for that. Now, last but not the least, that is low academic standards. In our enthusiasm to spread higher education, we have been opening many universities oblivious of their academic standards. Consequently, we have a large army of half-baked graduates and postgraduates whose sufficient skills only causes deficiency in the level of efficiency and productivity. So the academic standard just measured on the basis of degrees. Highly people are engaged in the process of thinking and making some technological changes or bringing some technological advancement to the nation. It's just not that meager degree will work. People need to raise their standards. So this low academic standard is also a problem in the process of human capital formation in India. So we have seen rising population, brain drain, insufficient manpower planning, insufficient on the job training in primary sector, and low academic standard as the problems which have been faced in human capital formation in India. Hope it is clear to you all.